Now, how an artist in the world of tap dancing is using tradition, breaking with it, and experimenting with a genre she discovered when she was just 3 years old. Jeffrey Brown profiles a choreographer who's lighting up the stage in New York this holiday season.
For tap dancing phenom Michelle Dorrance, the most important thing you need to know about her art form is this.
You dance to create music. Like, tap dance is the dance of creating music. Is it down
by the rushing? That means we, the audience, both watch and listen. And for Dorrance, the sound she seeks guide the movement.
In order to get this sound, I have to move my body this way. So the look of tap dance is often because we needed a hard toe or a heel or a toe drop. And because of those particular nuances, our body had to do this to execute that sound, and that's where the dance comes from. When people say to us, oh, I get it, it's music. And you're like, yes. But that's what drives us.
Since founding her company, Dorrance Dance, in 2011, she's helped lead a renaissance in tap, gaining attention for her own exuberant athletic style, arms, head, and feet in motion. She's choreographed full-length dances for her group, including ETM Double Down, where the focus on music is made explicit. As dancers step on wooden boards that function like electronic drum pads. She and the company are constantly touring, bringing new audiences to this tradition-bound dance form. In 2015, Dorrance was recognized with the so-called Genius Award from the MacArthur Foundation.
That was much better on a lot of levels.
And this hoofer is a trooper.
Sorry.
Fighting off a bout of laryngitis, she let us visit a recent rehearsal of a dance called Myelination at a Midtown Manhattan studio, and was happy to talk about her role as an evangelist for tap.
Some people use the word edutain or edutainment.
Yeah, that's what you see yourself doing.
Yeah, I mean, inside of the art form, you must constantly educate about the past. But, I mean, something we were charged with, speaking of tradition, by our masters and our elders of the jazz era, is that's what jazz was about. Having your own individual voice and pushing your expression forward. So inside of this tradition, which I want to always honor, you have to define yourself and define your voice as authentically yours.
Now 38, Dorrance grew up in North Carolina, dancing tap from age 3. She performed with the North Carolina Youth Tap Ensemble and later with the show Stomp. Her mother is a ballet dancer and teacher, founder of the Ballet School of Chapel Hill. Her father, head coach of the University of North Carolina's women's soccer team, and one-time coach of the USA women's team.
Somehow tap comes from that?
Yeah, we all joke about it because they both use their feet for their professions. Both of them have incredibly quick feet, so let's...
You got that, Gene.
Yeah, let's bring that here.
Quick feet are certainly one requirement for tap dancing, but it's also clear that Dorrance seeks diverse styles and personalities for her company. We watched her rehearse a duet with 22-year-old Byron Tittle.
Well, I met Michelle when I was 10 at a tap festival, and I've just been taking her classes and following her, kind of like a stalker, since then. For me, there's a push that Michelle puts under you and behind you that doesn't feel forceful, it feels encouraging. My life was made because Michelle asked me to do something that was crazy. It's full circle. It's really cool.
By contrast, 39-year-old Nicholas Young has known and danced with Dorrance since they were teens. And there's another obvious contrast, size.
That's something that people have been really excited about. The dancers that Michelle chooses, that she chooses a very diverse group of dancers, you know? And she allows each of us to express ourselves individually, while then at times creating a very specific image or a story or a feeling in her pieces. But then I think people really enjoy seeing all of us move out of that storyline and become ourselves. I think people relate. I actually get that a lot. I get guys coming to me after a show and being like, hey, you really made me feel like I could do this too. You know what I mean? Like, yeah, so I don't know.
That's a good feeling.
Yeah, that's so cool.
Yeah.
In her dance, The Blues Project, Dorrance directly addressed the role of tradition and history. For her and the other dancers we met, being part of a tradition and knowing that history is intrinsic to their lives in tap. Dorrance cites the recent impact of Savion Glover, whose Bringin' the Noise, Bringin' the Funk, first performed in 1995, was another revolutionary moment for the form. She's also acutely aware, as a white woman, that the history of innovation in tap has come largely from African Americans.
It is a black form. It's an African American form.
Yeah. So how do you think about the racial aspect?
It's really important to acknowledge it, and it's really important to share the history of the form and to say the names of dancers. To say the name Jimmy Slide, Dr. Jimmy Slide, Dr. Buster Brown, to say the names of Fayard and Harold Nicholas, Charlie Atkins, Honey Coles, to say the names of these men that aren't the first names that come to your mind. You think of a Fred Astaire or Gene Kelly because they were the heroes of the movie musical, but they were dancers behind the scenes. And there were dancers innovating the form that weren't on the screen, but they were the ones that were breathing fire into the form to make it exciting.
And not just men. Dorrance also cites women dancers who've been important to her. Diane Walker, Brenda Buffalino, Mabel Lee.
I feel very lucky to be a tap dancer, especially a woman as a tap dancer right now. I feel like I can jump into or be inspired by the style of a man or a woman, and it doesn't matter. And I won't be received as being something very specific. I'll just be received as a dancer or a musician.
Dorrance Dance performs in New York this holiday season and then resumes touring around the country in January. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Jeffrey Brown in New York.